Today, I'm going to talk about this mechanical memory and dosing influence stem cell fate. So previously, many scientists use tissue culture plate or glass for culturing the cell. But especially when you culture the stem cell over the subculture, like passage 1, passage 2, passage 10, the people already known that stemness can decrease over increase of subculture. So people, maybe they just in their mind, they think stemness somehow they are losing because of aging or because of some other reason, because in each passage we have to use trypsin to detach. So this kind of stress also can affect the stem cell stemness. But this paper, they mentioned besides this kind of trypsin attack or some aging, some mechanical memory can downregulate the stemness of the stem cell. So this is their fundamental finding, why they developed this, why they designed this experiment. So in shortly, they want to know the underlying mechanism why stemness can decrease in stiff tissue culture plate over subculture. And then they are answering based on the mechanobiology. So this is written by the Christie and Seth group. So first, they design. So they culture the stem cell. Maybe they are using human stem cell, or do you remember? Human bone marrow stem cell, right?
Yeah.
Human bone marrow derived stem cell, and then they culture 1, 3, 5, 7 days under gross media. Gross media means stem cell can maintain the stemness. They will not differentiate. Just using FBS or without any special growth factor, they just proliferate without any differentiation, not intentionally. So they termed this kind of 1 to 7 days culture as mechanical dosing. Dosing is some kind of duration, or when you dose something, you can, you can high dose, low dose. When you inject some drug or some treatment molecule, depending on the concentration, you can term as a dose, high dose, low dose. But here, they mimic this kind of medicine dosing as a mechanical dosing. Mm-hmm. So after 1 to 7 days, they found out LUNX2. LUNX2 is osteogenic gene. When LUNX2 is highly enhanced, which means the stem cell can more osteogenic. So over the increase of dosing on TCP, LUNX2 level increasing, which means without any chemical factor or growth factor, the stem cell can be osteogenic, right? But this is not unintentionally. Mm-hmm. So here they culture 1 to 7 days, and then they trypsinize the cell, they detach the cell, and then they move to the soft gel. TCP, the stiffness is around 10 gigapascal. You know, gigapascal?
Mm-hmm.
1,000 times less, megapascal. 1,000 times less, kilopascal. 1,000 times less, pascal. Okay? So TCP is 10 gigapascal. For soft hydrogel here, they are using maybe few kilopascal, right? Few kilopascal. And then they culture them three days on the soft. So, depending on, okay, so this is the human MSC nuclear localization. Okay, ABD. Okay, this is D, is without this soft change. They first check at this dosing, at the end of dosing, they check YAP belongs to nuclear localization. YAP, co-transcription factor, they can play a role when they are inside the nucleus. As you know, all protein, how they made it? First, the nucleus has DNA, right? DNA, the cell can transcript the DNA into the RNA. And then when RNA can go outside of nucleus, and then the RNA can be translated in protein. This is a concept of the central dogma, DNA, RNA, protein. So which means all kind of protein should be synthesized in the cytoplasm, not in nucleus. So when the protein should play a role inside of the nucleus, first they synthesize in outside of the nucleus, and then after that they can go inside. So this kind of transcription factor or co-transcription factor playing together with the transcription factor should go inside the nucleus to play a role. So why people look at the YAP belongs to as a nuclear localization? So YAP also increase of nuclear localization as a percentage over 7 days of culture on the stiff TCP as well as longs to. Okay, so YAP, they can manipulate many kind of transcription factor including longs to or many other transcription factor, like I'm not sure exactly, but maybe what else? Longs to and muscle transcription factor, MHC, my heavy chain, or yeah, many kind of transcription factor they can regulate. So okay, and up to D is okay, and then they change after 1 day of TCP, 3 days soft, 7 days TCP, 3 days soft. But YAP, as you know, they are easily go outside here, right? But in case of 7 days, they maintain the nuclear localization, so which means that depending on the mechanical dosing of TCP time, some cell they are losing the YAP nuclear localization like this, but some cell when they are exposed long time, they are staying in the nucleus. So they want to say that this kind of YAP nuclear localization as well as longs to can be some marker of the memory to the cell. So next, so people are asking, okay, I understand your phenomenon, but you trip Schneider cell, detach, and then centrifuge and seed again. This is very huge stress for the cell. How are you sure about your finding? This YAP is really mechanical memory? So for answering the question, this guy fabricate a special gel. This is a gel structure using PEG-D PDA. And then after culturing the cell using free radical polymerization, and then when they induce light again, the stiff gel can be softened. Okay? So this is the concept. So depending on the light exposure time, from 10 kPa and then 10 minutes of lightning, 6, another 30 seconds, 4, another 30 seconds, 2, right? So depending on how much you light expose, the stiffness of the gel can be decreasing, okay? So here, 3 gigapascal is tissue culture plate, stiff gel, 10 kilopascal, soft gel, 2 kilopascal. And then using this gel, you can do in situ softening. In situ means, how can I say? In situ, at that site. Yeah. At that site, you can change the softness of gel. So here, depending on the gel stiffness, maybe they individually make this gel, 2, 4, 6, 10, and they culture the human MSC, and then they found that over increase of stiffness, this is not dynamic, this is some static, And then 6 and 10, the YAB is highly nucleoside, but compared to 2 and 4. And then YAB, as well as LUX2, also go inside the nucleus, right? Very similarly. So this is their conformation individually. 2 kilopascal from initially, they culture the cell, and then on the soft shell, YAB go outside of the nucleus. But in case of 10, YAB can go inside, as well as LUX2. This is some static, okay? So using the soft gel platform, a gel platform, they can make 4 different kind of the stiffness, and then when they culture the stem cell individually, they also found a similar pattern when you look at the TCP. High stiffness, around 10 kilopascal, they are more prone to induce YAB or YAB and LUX2 nucleolocalization. Okay? And then, what is the next step? Next step, they want to perform in situ softening to prove their initial concept. Okay? So, they all culture the cell under gross media, 1, 7, 10 days on stiff gel, and then on 0 day, they induce lightening, and then because of this light, some gel can be soft from 10 to 2 kilopascal. Okay? And so this DTS1, 1 day stiff, and the softening, at softening, 1, 3, 5 days further culture. 7 days of stiffening, and then after softening, 1, 3, 5 day culture. Like that. So when you see stiff and soft, this white one, they permanently culture stiff and soft over like 7 days or 3 days. But this kind of black one, they culture stiff 1 day and change to soft. Stiff 1 day, soft 3, stiff 1 day, soft 5. When you see, let's imagine when your cell, stem cell, they never change the soft substrate. They always maintain the YAB around 90%, right? But when they change to the soft only 1 day, this 90 to change to 50. And then another 2 day, 50 to 20. Okay? And then this is very similar to only soft. And the YAB also like that. And then LUX2 also with 1 day, more dramatically decreasing. So this can be depicted in here. So this is 1 day stiff, and then let's say this is 7 days stiff. After seven days of stiffness, white one, when they never change the softness, the 90% of YAB and LUX2 you can detect. But when you change the soft for 1 day, this 30% decreasing, and then another 10 or 20% decreasing over increase of soft gel culture. You can also detect the LUX2, similar pattern. But this is interesting. When you see this kind of decreasing gap is a little bit diminished in 7 days of stiff culture, right? But in case of 10 days of stiff, what happened? The YAB and LUX2 level, in case of a YAB, also they never change it. Okay? They never go to the soft phenomenon. The YAB always can be nuclear localized. But LUX2, they are a little bit decreasing when they change the soft, but not that much of the real soft. So this is, we can say that this is irreversible. If you culture the cell on TCP or high stiffness substrate, after changing the stiffness to the soft, into 2 kilopascal, LUX2 and YAB, they never go to the natural soft type. But when you culture very short time, they can reversally go to the soft. They can be accustomed to soft. But when you culture for 5 or 7 days, some cell can go soft culture condition, but not absolutely. Okay? So this right paragraph is very good to understand this whole picture. Reversible, all reversible, partial reversible, and then non-reversible, which means irreversible. So they want to say this kind of YAB maybe can be a mechanical memory protein. And then, okay, what's the meaning of this mechanical memory? So now, after 7 days of 10 days of different culture time, they change the soft hydrogel, and then they culture the stem cell under mixed differentiation media. Mixed means half adipogenic, half osteogenic. Okay, so without any mechanical dosing, when you culture on the soft gel, most of the cell can go adipogenic. None of them can go as to osteogenic, right? So this can be detected. So this OLEDO is adipogenic marker. They are highly expressed in soft gel. This ALP positive cell is an osteogenic marker. They are highly expressed in stiff gel. So let's imagine, when you culture the cell on soft, all stem cells can go adipogenic. When you culture the cell on the stiff, all can go osteogenic. But when you change 5-10 days of stiff culture and then change to the soft gel, what will happen? Okay, so first they check the gene expression. PPAR gamma is a adipogenic marker. ALP gene is osteogenic marker. Adipogenic marker decreasing when you culture the cell on the stiff hydrogel, stiff TCP here, TCP over time. 10 TCP culture can diminish PPAR gamma. But when you culture them, ALP gene expression, they can go high, right? Over increase of mechanical dosing. And then really, this is a gene expression, but this ALP positive cell, so next, they want to check gene and then protein level by ICC. When they check green, PPAR gamma protein level, OCN is osteogenic protein. PPAR gamma highly expressed in soft, but over increase of dosing 1, 5, 10 days, most of them they are expressed only OCN, not red, not green color. Also, this can be confirmed by ALP staining, violet color, which is osteogenic marker, and this is quantified in here. So overall, depending on how many days you culture the stem cell on stiff substrate, when you change to the soft gel, even the cell fate change differently depending on how long time, how many days did you culture the stem cell on stiff gel or TCP. Actually, in here they didn't use hydrogel, but when you imagine, when they use even the stiff gel, maybe the similar pattern will be detected. So this is the end of the story. Okay, any question? Conceptualize the what is the aging. Mm-hmm. So aging only found in eukaryotic animal or eukaryotic organism. Yeah, organism. For example, in case of bacteria, mm-hmm. bacteria don't have any aging. Mm-hmm. Did you ever heard about bacteria aging? Never. But in case of human aging, cell aging, or plant also. Plant, does it have any nucleus? Plant. Actually, I'm not sure of the plant, but most of the organism which has nucleus, they have aging phenomenon. So, and then in that case, so cell, they definitely adjust their behavior depending on their microenvironment, right? But The meaning of the aging is when you are young, you easily sense and touch and feel the microenvironment around you, and then you can adjust easily. This is a very normal, healthy feature, but over time, this kind of sensing poor, or when you sense you perfectly, but during the transmission from the touch, the tip of your finger to the brain, something blocked or something miscommunicated, this can be explained as aging. Now people think about the concept of aging like that in terms of the mechanobiology. This is some transmittance of signal from the outside to the inside. Inside means nucleus, outside in extracellular matrix, some gel or some external force or some other light or any kind of thing. The cell, when they do not properly perceive the external signal, is called aging nowadays. So, like you mentioned, but not much of the report about aging in terms of mechanobiology. So maybe you have to check other literature how they approach. But at the moment, as you already know, laminase is somehow nucleus membrane protein, or this very key protein can transmit the outer signal from the cell outer environment to the nucleus. So when the laminase is destroyed or some malformed, this kind of external transmittance can be inhibited, so which can be expressed as an aging of a cell. So, for example, if we want to overcome this kind of aging of a cell, human aging, what can we do? Which means how we can maintain our proper external signal transmittance to the nucleus. So for answering the question, we have to know in normal cell or in cell at the moment how they are aged in terms of mechanobiology. So which kind of some step can be inhibited over aging. This can be understood on culture plate, tissue culture plate culturing over time, and then you can check which kind of mechanotransmittance can be inhibited. And then let's say if you find one aging is very highly expressed firstly, but over aging passage 5, 10 or 15, this gene is highly diminished, and then we can see this gene can be a major player for regulating aging in terms of mechanobiology. For that, we have to use maybe TCP or different stiffness gel or other kind of platform we can use it. Scientists want to find the mechanism. If you find one mechanism, let's say stiffness-dependent some gene which can link to the telomere length, so you can find this ABC mechanism, and then from the your candidate of the 10,000 molecule, you can screen out which one can majorly regulate this pathway. And then when you find 10 from the in vitro, and then you can do in vivo, and then you can sort out to number 2 or 3, and then you can perform clinical study for human, and then you can finally recapitulate this one through the 1,000 target, 1,000 candidate, you can find the target therapeutic drug for curing this phenomenon. So this is some concept.
And is there possible to see also the